Hello students, hope you are doing great. I am Revan Siddhaya, your physics educator only at KLM Institute. Today's topic under physics is light, reflection and refraction. We have covered the reflection part of it in the part 1 of this video. We'll move on to the refraction of light in this video. Students, to understand refraction of light, we'll perform this particular experiment. This is a very small experiment and a very simple experiment. You can take a glass of water. The glass should be clear. You can add anything to it. You can add pencil or pen. You can see the pencil has changed shape. It is a bit curvy or it has been displaced from its natural path. That is the in the air, what is in the top of this glass? There is air in this glass, okay, all around it. And here down below, there is water. So the light, the speed of light is changing in other mediums. So to understand refraction, this is very important, students. The speed of light varies from one medium to other. So let's, you can perform this experiment too. Draw an arrow in this direction, and if you place a glass similar to this, if you place a glass, you can see the arrow changes its direction. Now we all know that light travels in different speeds in different medium. So when you pass a light through one medium to another, the propagation of light changes. This is nothing but refraction. You can read the definition once more. Light traveling obliquely. Obliquely is in a slant way, students, this way. If the medium is like this, this is obliquely. When light travels obliquely from one medium to another, the direction of propagation of light in the second medium changes. This is called as refraction of light.
Register today at KLM Institute for free online classes, revisions, doubt clearance, private online and offline classes, Olympiad exams, and win prizes, scholarships, and much more.
To understand the refraction of light, now let us perform an activity. Take a glass and place it on a paper. And the end points of the glass mark it as A, B, C, D. You can see here as represented in the picture. So now you will get two mediums. Which, what are those? That is air and glass. Now you can place two pins, that is E and F here. You can see in the diagram. And the image of E and F will be in the G and H points, let's call it that. And you can draw this line called AB. You can trace out the outline of the glass on the paper. Now you can remove the glass of glass outside, and you can join this point, that is E and F. You can take a scale and join E and F and extend it till where it reaches the AB line. This is the AB line. This is A, this is B. This you can see here, this is the AB line. Then here in the down part, you can connect G and H and extend it till it touches the CD line. We can call this O dash and this point as O. So you can later join the O and O dash. Now you can see here, this represents a ray of light. The E and F part is not just two pins. These are line in a straight line. You can see here when it touches the point O, that is when it changes medium, it's traveling in a different path than which it has to. Then again, it travels in the same angle which is it's directed to. So this is refraction of light, students. Now let's see what is its actual path. This is its actual path. It has to come here to the point P, but it has come to the point H. So now draw a line perpendicular to AB at point O. This line, let's call it as N N dash. You can find the angle of incidence and angle of refraction here. And you can find the same similar line here, that is M M dash, which is perpendicular to C D. Here you can find an incident ray I2 and refracted ray R2. Why there are two incidents and two refraction angles here? Can anyone tell? Yes, because light is traveling from one medium to another. That is just one incidence and one refraction. But again, it exits the medium. That is, it is exiting glass here. So you can see another incident ray and another refracted ray. Understanding the activity, let us move on to the laws of refraction. The first law says the incident ray, the refracted ray, and the normal to the interface of two transparent materials at the point of incident. What is this? This is N to N dash. This is the line they are mentioning. All these three lie in the same plane. This is the first law of refraction. The next law of refraction, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence. Angle of incidence is here. I'll take a different color to show you. Yeah, this is angle of incidence. This is the angle of refraction. The sine of angle of incident to the sine of angle of refraction, the ratio of these both is a constant. Let us read the statement. The ratio of sine of the angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is a constant for the light of given color and for given pair of media. That is, if the color changes, that if you shine a blue light, it is different, and if you shine a green light, it is different. So they are mentioning that. And this is also known as Snell's law of refraction. If I is the angle of incidence and if R is the angle of refraction, then here you can see this is an important formula. I will tell you in a minute why. Sine I divided by sine R is a constant. Note, this is only true between the angles 0 to 90. Angle of incidence should be 0 to 90 degrees. Okay. Sine I divided by sine R should be a constant. So what is this constant?
Give your imagination wings. If you are willing to write something, what are you waiting for? Share your ideas and thoughts. Let your ideas reach out to millions. Get your articles published through our blogs for free.
Yes, it is the refractive index. Let's make a small derivation here. Let V1 be the speed of light in medium 1 and V2 be the speed of light in medium 2. All right. Then the refractive index of the medium 2 with respect to medium 1 is N. It is represented by N in the subscript 2 to 1, that is N 2 to 1 is equal to speed of light in the medium 1 divided by speed of light in the medium 2, that is V1 divided by V2. Respectively, very similarly, you can find out what is the refractive index of medium 1 with respect to medium 2. That is represented by N 1 to 2. It is equal to speed of light in the medium 2 divided by speed of light in the medium 1. Please don't get confused here. And it is represented by V2 divided by V1. But students, most of the time we take medium 1 as air. So if that is the case, the refractive index of medium 2 is considered with respect to vacuum. This is because air has very low refractive index. This is called as absolute refractive index of the medium, which is represented by NM. nm is given by speed of light in air divided by speed of light in a medium, which is equal to c divided by v. Now let us look at refractive index of common materials. What are these materials? These are oftenly used while calculate refractive index, so it is just easy to remember their refractive index. Air, I told you the refractive index is very negligible. It is just 1.0003, and refractive index of ice is 1.31. And this is very important, refractive index of water, 1.33. These are all common materials. You can go through the table later and you can see the diamond, the refractive index of diamond is 2.4, students. It is very high. So students, just like in the case of mirrors, there are two types of lenses when we study about spherical lenses. There is double convex lens and double concave lens. Convex lens is bulged in both sides. The center part, you can see here, this center part is very broad, and as it reaches the ends, this is very narrow. It is the opposite in double concave lens. The ends are very broad, but the center part is narrow. Let's study some of the terminologies associated with spherical lenses. So students, if you have watched the first part of this video, you will understand this very easily. So just like in spherical mirrors, there is center of curvature, but in case of spherical lenses, you can imagine two spheres. In case of convex lens, it is like this, and in case of concave lens, it is like this. All right, the center of this sphere, these both imaginary spheres, is known as center of curvature. So you can label it as C1 and C2. There are two center of curvatures here, and an imaginary line passing through both of these. A straight line passing through both of these is called the principal axis, and we can call the center of this mirror. It is equidistant from point M and point N. These are the ends of the mirror, students. You can see this is the center of the mirror, sorry, lens, and you can call this point as O. This is a very shabby picture. I will show you in a neat way.